Welcome to the latest edition of the SWR podcast. That's our best. This is setting the tone for the episode.
Yeah, sorry, but for some reason my Apple Watch decided that. Hey, yeah, I just said oh yeah. It said oh yeah. I'm like, I didn't activate you. Why are you trying to speak? Does that ever happen to you? Like your phone's just like, I didn't quite understand what you meant by that. Anyway, I interrupted the intro.
That's all right. Wrestler Darth went through a period of kept saying Alexa, so I couldn't listen to it in the living room because that just ruined that. Anyway, right, intro. I am joined this week by Kickass, the shooter, 169 pounds of pure energy, the meme machine, the filthy Frank of Scottish wrestling, the Borat of banter, the Twitch twink, the old gran, the bad back, the sneezy boy, baby Broda, Old Spice, but twice as nice. The TikTok Technodrome. Bigger pops than Funko. Putting the Owen Monster. The Relentless Red Bull. The Supreme Smacker.
The Owen Monster?
SWM Podcast Award winner. Take a shot. Ian. Principal. Skinner. Pew Pew. The Annoying Guy. And he killed Sparky too.
Oh, how dare you? How dare you? Here's the thing. I've got the knife out. I'm gonna eat my cucumber just now. But obviously, I'm not gonna use my teeth. So I use a knife. Isn't it weird how just all of a sudden, like Agatha was like, or Agnes, like, oh sorry, it's been out for a month now. Okay, by this point, we've been out for a month and a week because like the episode only dropped recently. Why am I suddenly more attracted to her now that I know that she's evil? But then it's like, and here's the thing. I'm really specific about what I find attractive. But for some reason with Agatha, I can overlook the fact that she killed a dog because she's that evil. And I'm like, oh, damn, it's just spicy at this point. Question. I'm going to start off with a question. Why does McDonald's Sprite, I tweet this as well because I need the answer. Why does McDonald's Sprite taste like the noise that cats make when they hiss?
Sprite sucks. So
No, but it's not about Sprite in general. I can have a Sprite, you know. I'm not like, I don't, like, I think Sprite tastes more healthier than Coke because... I don't know, Coke is just basically just syrup. Sprite syrup, but there's a hint of, like, you know, fruit in it. So, you know, you feel like you're choosing the healthier option. But McDonald's Sprite is something else. McDonald's Sprite tastes like TV static. McDonald's Sprite tastes somehow spicy. It's somehow spicy, despite the fact that... Here's another one. Right, so... You buy hot wings, like a nice, like Inferno sauce wings, right? Cool. Leave them out for a day, even put them in the fridge. You take them out. Are they still hot wings? They'll taste hot, but they'll be cold. Bruh.
So that'd be minty wings, because mint's just cold spice.
Mint is cold spicy, I agree there, but also people do get angry at me when I kind of try to go on a tirade about cold spicy. But mint is tangy. It's more tangy than it is spicy. Unless you've got like airwaves, in which it's kind of like, I don't know how to say it, but it's like having like an industrial fan inside your mouth. Have you ever used like a mint bath bomb?
No, but the thing that came to my head was Original Source shower gel mint.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, imagine Original Source shower gel, because obviously you put it on the thing and it goes, your skin starts screaming. Imagine bathing in that, because I once did a mint bath bomb. It was the worst decision I'd ever made, because I was sitting in the bath, I was chilling. I'm like, oh, the bath's kind of getting a bit more cold than, you know, I like it to be. So I was going to get out. I was like, okay, it'll be colder outside. No, mint bath bomb. My pores are open. It's breathing. I get out the bath. I'm like, oh, God. I'll get back in the bath, but it's still cold. But it's colder outside. And then I get out and my whole body is breathing.
I feel like you've turned into Dr. Manhattan.
Yeah, it feels like that. I feel like I'm about to explode and go, and then like I turn into a skeleton. And then it was pain because you know, you try to do a towel doesn't warm it up because your body is like breathing. Your body is breathing. I'm like, cool. That's my, the thing I did was a hairdryer, but because it's blowing air onto your pores, it sparks that cold sensation, but it's also warming you up. So it just like evens itself out. It's the never buy a mint bath bomb. What's the most poisonous thing to your body that you still eat?
Oh God.
I
still like energy drinks, so probably that I would think. Although I get gout, so anything with red meat and vinegar, I really shouldn't be eating or having in general, because if I have too much vinegar and don't regulate it with medication.
Gout is the most medieval shit. Like, how the fuck do people still get gout? Like, are you literally like Henry VIII? Do you just sitting at home just eating a leg of chicken?
Oh, I wish.
There's a comedy show with Bob and David. So it was Bob Odenkirk and David Cross. And one of the skits that they had was a guy who's like, told us that, okay, you can't eat, you know, meat anymore. And he's like, no, but like, so I can like low down it. And the doctor's like, no, your cholesterol's so high that if you eat meat, you will die. And he's like, but even like a bit of chicken. And I was like, no, I'm being serious. The doctor's like, I'm being serious. You can't eat meat, okay? You will die. And then there's a second skit where it's a bunch of guys sitting around a poker table and they're talking about their life aspirations. One of them's like, I want to be a priest. I want to be the president. Oh, I want to make a new phone. And then it gets to him and he's like, I just want to, as you know, been thinking about, you know, quitting eating meat. And they're like, okay, can you stop being a dick? He's like, what? No, I'm just like, he's like, oh, so you love me. You're not going to quit meat. He's like, well, no, I need to, because the doctor said I'll die. He's like, oh, don't be a dick. Just because I want to be the Pope, okay? Doesn't mean you have to make some unrealistic expectation just to take the piss out of the fact that I want to be Pope. And then, like, the sketch goes on, they're getting annoyed at him because he's setting an unrealistic expectation. And they're like, oh, we should order a pizza. And they're like, okay, so we'll get large meat lovers. And he's just like, well, can you just get one that's just cheese? And they're like, okay, don't keep, it's not, okay, the joke's not funny anymore, okay? So they don't order a pizza that's just cheese, and they're just like sitting there eating pizza. And it's like, John went on to become the president. Neil went on to become the Pope. This guy went on to make a new phone. And then and it shows the guy is like upset. And then he eats a slice of pepperoni pizza. And then it cuts to the end where he's just like in a hospital bed. And, and he just eats a sausage and flatlines. I'm lactose intolerant, but I still eat pizza all the time because, like, it's literally poison to me. Like, my body is literally like, can you stop? And I'm like, but everyone's like, oh, I have vegan cheese. Or like,
oh God.
Not my cucumber. Oh, I have vegan cheese. Or I have it just like, you know, take off the cheese. It's not the same. It's like, oh, I have a burger without the meat, without the sauce, without the bread, you know?
Well, last year we went through a corn day because I bought corn thinking, oh, it'll be healthier and I really shouldn't have as much meat anymore because I've got gout. And yeah, it lasted one meal and we're like, no.
It's not the same. I tried vegan sausages and it just like, I had like vegan sausage like sandwich. Like, I was just like, oh, damn. I just had to lather it in sauce to get some flavor out of it because it just didn't taste. What's better, a greasy spoon bacon roll or primary school cake?
Oh, there's a question. I would go greasy spoon bacon roll only because I'm going to say like a right dick during this. I like custard. And I really
you can get primary school cake without the custard.
Yeah, but everyone else had custard, and I feel like they would look down on me for getting the cake without custard. Like,
well, here's the thing: like I get greasy spoon bacon rolls without the marge or butter. I'm not a fan of butter or marge. So that's my kind of like margarine is the custard of greasy foods.
I do like greasy spoon. It used to be my tradition for going work night outs because I would just get absolutely paralytic. And I would always go Wetherspoons, even though they are the devil. Wetherspoons fry up the next day, like £4 and all the meat. Best thing. But
I mean, with what we know now, Billy, maybe wasn't the best decision.
I know, I was putting pounds in the pockets of Tories. How dare I?
Well, not even that, but the gout.
Oh, yeah, that as well. Oh, yeah,
the gout. Well, every time I got drunk, you know, I'd have a Weatherspoon's greasy spoon. I used to get drunk 5 days a week. Well, that explains it, Billy. What I had to do, I had to drink away the sadness of having a Weatherspoon's greasy spoon. Like, no, Billy, that's what happened. Billy, I'm your doctor now, okay? What prevents people from doing good Linkin Park covers? Why is everyone trying reinventing the wheel when they're doing that shit? Like, come on.
I'm trying to think of any cover that I've heard of, because it's just sounds like a garbled mess. Because you can't beat the originals.
Exactly. But everyone's trying to reinvent the wheel. I heard like some guy do a cover of Paper Cut, and then he's trying to do some. It's like, no! We didn't like the song because, like, we liked the song because there was just like energy, emotion, passion. We didn't like it because Chester was a good singer. He just happened to be a good singer. And we only realized that when we tried, like, someone's like, okay, we'll try to in the end at like a karaoke. And then you go, I tried so hard. And then you're like, whoa, damn, that was actually how do you have that lung capacity? You know, when you listen to Given Up for the first time, you didn't recognize that the scream went on for so long, like 17 seconds, until you went, okay, let's try scream along to the song. And then you're like,
I remember I only got Hybrid Theory because my mum decided at the time that I was too young to get Limp Bizkit, Chocolate Starfish, and the hot dog flavored water. So I got Hybrid Theory instead.
Mate. Great album. Aged a lot better than bloody, like, Chocolate Starfish. Like, name four songs off of Chocolate Starfish.
I assume it's all the ones I only know of Limp Bizkit. My Way. Rolling.
Yep.
I don't know, it's Behind Blue Eyes on that one.
I don't think so, no. I think that's when they went into that experimental fucking... Like, so, now name
Crack
four
addict.
Songs...
Crack Addict. There you go.
But now name four songs off the Hybrid Theory.
Oh, no. I can't remember. In the end...
One Step Closer, like, Paper Cut, In the End, Crawling.
Crawling. I used to have that my paper round. I would rip it and put it onto my...
Wow, that was... Damn.
I had a Walkman. I had a Walkman when I did my paper round. That's how old I am. And it would skip every so often because I had to have it on top of my papers.
Yeah.
And
Shit, yeah, because you used to have the little jack thing, and sometimes it felt like the jack was like jostled.
Yeah,
like the song would just.
Which was all right, but yeah, when I had Blink-182 in there, some of the songs were like really quiet and then they would kick in, so I didn't know if they were working or not, and suddenly it would just like explode in my ear, which is not great when I'm trying to put a Sunday Post in a letterbox.
Have I ever told you about APPW?
No.
Okay, so this is like, it's copyright, you know, we can share this if it's my idea for a promotion. Austin Powers Pro Wrestling, okay? I've already got the first show, like, lined up and booked, okay? Like, it's a 5-match card. I won't give away all the matches, but I'll give you the main ones that everyone will be tuning in for, right? Main event, obviously, Austin Powers versus Dr. Evil. You've got the middle match, you've got Mini-Me versus Fat Bastard. And then, the best one, the six-woman tag with the Fembots versus the Fembots. So, the grey gun Fembots versus the pink Fembots. Bruh. I'm being real here. Like, if anyone books APPW before this, this is the evidence, you know? This is, I've told a lot of people about it. Fucking don't move. Like, I'm being real. Like, I straight up will do this at some point. I'll get round to it. I'll need to buy, like, the trademarks first off. But that's all, like, supplementary. Damn.
So we're able to secure number three. It's number three coming along as well. You know?
Number two. Come on. Billy. Number two.
Oh, you got to get number three in.
Who? Mole. Molly.
It's actually Emily Hayden's question. She's put, what's your favourite Austin Powers quotes?
It's a very I could literally just name, like, list the whole film, but the one thing that always gets me, because it's a nice, it's a subtle one, it's not one of the ones that everyone's like, okay, it's like immediately this one, I'd say one top one, it's not even a quote, but it's a great moment, is when it cuts to Mini-Me. It's like, hey assholes, I'm Mini-Me over here, come get me. It's played by Danny DeVito, but it's in Austin Powers Goldmember, in which it's like Michael Caine, and he's like, listen, Goldmember, don't play the laughing boy. And Goldmember goes, like, ah, oh, such a great subtle gag. That is just, like that. I love that whole film. Austin Powers Goldmember is the PWG of Austin Powers films. It's just like joke after joke after joke after joke after joke.
Oh yeah, we can't have pancakes in this household without going into
Schmorkin a pancake.
Bong in a bin.
Bong in a blitz. Sugar on a waffle. Flapjack in a cigarette. Pipe in a crepe.
Yeah, and anything small. I thought it smelled cabbage. You know, it's all classics.
What are you doing? You don't even have a name tag, do you? just fall over. I'm not going to even... what's your favourite TikTok trends?
Also, our personal favourite is Dr. Evil. I used to think you're crazy. Now see you're nuts. Oh, thank you. TikTok trends. Right. Now, I have TikTok. So it's been just about, 8 months since we last spoke. And since I've tried to be
cool. I've got hair now.
I have less, but that's why I'm wearing a hat. TikTok trends. I don't know. I'm still confused with TikTok. I seem to still be in the phase where, even though I don't ask it to, I get a lot of boobs. It's just because I'm a dude.
I think that's a TikTok thing in which, like, if you're a guy, that, like, they'll market this stuff towards dudes. I've got a list here of little ones that are good. What's that? It's a guy who, like, he just, like, films himself.
Oh, and he's, yes, just, like, aye. Guy, he's got the what's beard.
You know what I... And, like, there's the one that he did today. No one fucking clip this out of context because there's a joke to it. And he's like, you know what? I hate trans people. What's that? No, it's because, like, they're annoying, you know? Make a decision, you know? Like, what's that? No, transient people. Like, people who won't stay in one place, you know? They'll move around. What's that? Oh, you think that people will think I'm... No, wait, no! Like, I love that kind of shit. Like, just saying something, but, like, digging yourself a hole. Like, I accidentally did on the Yearn Simmons First Trap Extravaganza. I don't know if you've tuned into that.
No, I heard about it, and I went to go through Yearn Simmons.
Yeah, it's like Jesus... Twitch. Just has, like...
Yeah,
just
it's like got a posture at the end, but how to actually just say it. Ian Simmons' Twitch channel to try and find some clips of these things, but unfortunately, they seem to have been scrubbed. So what Hell happened yeah. on that with Jesse and Ian Simmons and Mad Kurt, etc.?
And American hero Jackson Stone. Don't forget the American hero Jackson Stone. Tom Huber, Shea Persa, Santos and Benny the Snake. It was a great episode. So it's a Twitch dating show that Ewan Simmons does, where it's kind of like The Bachelor, in which, like, you come on with the intention of either, you know, wanting to go on a date with this person or trapping them, and then they either have to subscribe to your OnlyFans or, like, PayPal your $5 or, like, essentially just, like, essentially you get benefits or, like, gift subs to you. So just Jesse or, like, Jesse Watches, whatever, like, she goes by multiple different egos, but Jesse was on it, and I was in it, and we were to introduce ourselves, and I was like, cool, I'm Ian Skinner, and, like, things that are heavy and funny, and then, like, I talk about, like, you know, I'm just, like, I'm out here, you know, like, you know, I'm just wanting to find love, you know, I say some mad prolific thing, like, you know, I learned to love myself, but I need to learn how to, like, share this love. And then Mad Kurt's first thing was, did you just call Jesse heavy? I'm like, wait, no. Like, and then I spent the whole episode backpedaling because I'm like, well, not backpedaling, just explaining myself. I'm like, no, I like heavy music, like heavy weights, like comedy. I like comedy. I like heavy stuff. I'm not, here's the thing. I chose trap. So at the end of the day, like, it's just like, I like heavy things. Yeah, Jesse isn't one of them. Or the, no, separate it. She's not. I don't, I'm not calling her heavy. This is a real sensitive topic to me because it's following me wherever I go, because all the people that were in Yearn's chat at the time will then go to the other chat. And then when one person messages it, everyone's like, well, what do you mean by that? And then like the people go, oh, actually, well, Ian Skinner, and I'll be in the chat and like, wait, no. Anyway.
Yeah, so yeah.
I went out in the second round.
I saw there was a poem about you as well. Well, it was for Jesse, but ended up just being a bit of a dig at you. Yearn did send in a question. He just put simply, what's popping? So thank you, Yearn, for getting a question in there.
Fuck! Oh! What's popping?
And here's us thinking, well, we'll do it clean. We won't get any swearing. Yeah, oh. This is definitely explicit. This is going to be an explicit episode. So, fuck. May as well just get them all in.
What's popping?
Right.
Something like, what's my favorite swear?
Oh, why not? Go for it at this point.
Sheet.
Nice simple one. Just, I mean, obviously, as a Scotsman, I like the classics.
So there's the guy who puts his hand in the sandwich and he's got like Viola is Murder playing, and it's like people who are racist puts the bread on his hand and he's already holding a slice of bread, knuckle sandwich. Tourette's TikTok, that's a great
yes,
one.
Sweet Anita,
she's great. Oh, she's a Twitch streamer, but like the highlights on there are great.
Ironically.
And there's a guy who's like called Uncle Tix. And it's just him trying to like play Jenga, but he's like.
Oh, is it the same guy who also does cooking with his wife?
Yeah. And he's just like, egg! Oh, sorry. He's just like so polite afterwards.
I know, and it's just like Simba. Yeah.
Tourette's TikTok, it's not like funny, but it's good that people are like getting some, like creating some entertainment value out of kind of like the everyday kind of like. Struggles that they have. Anyway, that's too serious. Deathcore vocalists singing some like just like songs like Barbie Girl and shit, because I appreciate that stuff. And, like there was one where and he'll do like there's a guy who's like he just replies to this woman who's like, oh, do you have a case of the Mondays? Obviously, it's a Garfield thing, so he's just like in his car freaking out. He's like, I would try a lasagna. It's like Garfield. Soggy Nugget, that's a great one where it's like, do you have a TV license, sir? It's just like all these just random shit where it's like a police. Oh, I've sworn! No!
You've already thrown in fucks and shits fairly loosely. Yes. So, anyone watching, Lisa, it took me a while to realize that if I put my YouTube videos as not for kids, it actually increases views. So, it's fine. I'll just put the big E next to it. Not big E. Best slap of meat.
Like the meme, like the E meme. Of like Lord Farquaad.
Oh, I'm thinking of Mini-Me, you know, when he gets kicked.
Wait, see if I can, if you bear with me. I don't know if you've seen any of the Soggy Nuggets videos. There's one where it's like, oh, I need an egg. And then this like mad ghoul demon comes into the room. And
oh, yeah, like, he's got a white mask and he's got like black and all. He's...
Yeah, I love that. Like, that is like, that's my life. I actually live with one of those people. Here's the thing. I could not. You'll never know, Billy. You'll never know. Don't try and track me down because I will,
I mean, some people say Ian Skinner's not even your real name. So, who knows?
And those people are liars, okay? I'm out in these streets, okay? I'm just trying to find a wife, a kid, Oh, can I backtrack?
In which order? Wife,
I don't know. Oh, god damn, man. I'm trying to find this e-meme because it's great. I love the e-meme. Give me some more e things that make you go e. I can't right click. Why can't I right click? Anyway, and duetting videos where the person like goes up to like turn off the camera and then the person's there like, like those are absolutely peak.
Breaking news: Aspen Faith has retweeted your last call for
oh, interesting
pre-orders. That's it.
Here's the thing: Aspen Faith made some like bear hug designs, you know, whatever. Well, it was Bear Hug Designs. What's his new Instagram called? He did one for like Star Wars, and it was like the good, the bad, and the ugly. And
I'll call it Bosk.
Aurek form. Yeah. A U R E K F O R N. Yeah, he made one that's called The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. And then it was like the good guys, the bad guys, and then the ugly guys. And he had Bosk at the front and center. Listen, Bosk is a handsome motherfucker, okay? That lizard, dog man thing. He's great. Best bounty hunter in the town. Then he corrected himself saying, well, oh no, Bosk isn't ugly. You know, Bosk, like, he's just, like, done some ugly work. What's the most cursed YouTube video you ever watched?
Oh god, back in my youth, a cursed as in it keeps coming back to me, because that stupid Harry Potter one, which is what's it called? Snape. Severus Snape.
The mysterious ticking noise.
Yeah, that one seems to come back in my life far too often than it needs okay. to.
I think we've got two different definitions of cursed, but yeah. I've got do you know Blank Room Soup? I think it's called Blank Room Soup.
You know what? For someone who spends his day in front of a computer, I have very little knowledge of anything YouTube-y. Except obviously the SWM podcast, which everyone should be going watching, because, you know, it's acceptable.
Yeah. Blank Room Soup is this video where essentially there's a guy who's eating soup, and then, like, this mad, I don't know, this, like, big, like, guy with, like a mascot. It's kind of like a mascot, but like also not a mascot at the same time, like, comes over and starts patting him on the back, and the guy's like crying while he's eating this soup. And then another guy comes in the same costume, comes in, and they're like, you know, they're kind of like protecting him, and then one of them kind of like, wait, no, so one of them's patting, and then the other one comes in like a door at the back and just like stands and watches. And then it's like goes on for like a solid minute, and then he, like, all of a sudden the guy in the back just starts running towards the camera, like violently, and then like it just cuts out.
Yeah, I was done with those kind of videos with the whole maze thing.
Scary maze game, yeah. But here's the thing, this one isn't. Yeah, the ghost car advert. I found a video online that's the ghost car advert, but it actually, like, someone's, like, edited it so that the car actually comes out the other side. And it's just called, I wonder where he's going. And, like, it's cured my anxiety behind that video, because like, I'd literally, like, engage my fight or flight senses whenever I'd, like, watch, like, even just see a screenshot of it. Like, my body would, like, tense up and shit. Oh, fuck! Ah! I'm trying to not swear, guys. I'm trying to be a good boy. But it's kind of like cure my anxieties. Here's the thing. I think there's a lot more value, kind of like a horror movie as well. There's a lot more value in not having, you can be scarier without a jump scare. You know, a jump scare is cheap, but something that will literally stay with you. Like in the movie It, like the new It. The one where the boys just read the book, and then you've got the... like the old librarian woman just like standing in the back looking at him. That's the thing. I was just like, oh god. But then you've got like other cheap jump scares in that film, and I'm like, no, I don't want like cheap things.
Like TikTok and a stupid fucking spider.
Oh,
there's his spider. Every so often it'd be like someone goes, oh, what's in this box, and they pick up the box, and the spider just goes straight to the screen.
Like, yeah,
Fuck that.
Oh yeah, no, I like if it's sus, I look at the comments. Especially, I hate spiders. Like, that's my biggest fear. Spiders, bees, knee-high socks, black magic.
Well, the Lubbock song. Yeah, it's not the best one.
Yeah. And then, like BTS stands absolutely give me the fear. Because here's the thing. I don't want to say why they give me the fear. Because I know that I'll get cancelled. Just like they'll go, oh, you don't like BTS? Like, here's your bank account number. Here's your address. Oh, and they just like, they'll just say some cryptic shit. And like, I'll be like scared for my life. They'll say, well, guess what? Here, red, orange, BA927. You know what that means. I know what that means. Delete the tweet, Ian. I'm scared for something like that to happen. Who do you think wins the State of Your Hair, Mate award this year?
Oh, okay. I mean, Big Boris must be a heavy contender. He always is. Mm-hmm. I'm going to throw out Sam Gradwell just to get into the wrestling kind of fever.
I respect it. Like, it's kind of like the Bull Nakano thing, in which is like, damn, that mohawk stays up. Bruh. And he's committed to it. Like, he's unwaveringly kind of like, this is what I'm doing. I'm sticking to it. The most precise mohawk out there. Here's a sleeper hit. Matt Hancock. State of your hair, mate. Like, you see the push-up picture? Like, literally, like, he's got the quiff. He's got the quiff. And, like, looking like at, like, Matt Hancock like this, you're like, okay, it looks normal. But he's got the push-up picture where he's, like, face down. The quiff is, like, right up back here. You seeing it?
I'm looking at it now.
Can you share the screen?
No, because I'm using this on my computer. This is on the laptop. Is this the jumping the fence? I've got to jump. Oh, there's the push-up one.
Yeah.
There we go.
State your hair, mate.
Oh, it's the glare as well. Doesn't help.
Yeah, like the sun's hitting it, and it's just like pure shining back at the screen. Because I think sometimes the state of your hair, mate, isn't about kind of like the actual process of it going. I think it's about the person like rocking it and like some like it's infallibility. Is that the right word? Let me Google infallibility. See, I've got great words, and sometimes I'll use them with confidence, and people will just take it at face value. Infallibility, the inability to be wrong. Yeah. Yeah, I think that works. It doesn't work for the context I've used it, but yeah, infallibility does work for Matt Hancock. Anyway, back to my notes. What's the best Wallace and Gromit quote?
I mean, is it anything other than cracking cheese, Gromit?
It doesn't have to be from Wallace. Like, that's a good Wallace quote, but overall, let me get you this one. If you ask me, I tell you what, if you ask me, it were arson. Arson? Yeah, someone arson around.
Is that Curse the Were-Rabbit?
Yeah.
Of course it is.
The two best gags in Wallace and Gromit history, that one and the A-Up magazine. Oh, yes. Give me more of that. Inject Wallace and Gromit into my veins. I want to be the Wallace and Gromit of pro wrestling.
We'll add that to your list of what did you think of my extra ones I've thrown in there? Do you want me to go through
Broda?
Them? Got Baby Broda. Yeah.
I like that one.
Old Spice, but twice as nice. Thought that was kind of
that's cool.
The TikTok Technodrome.
That actually feeds into the what's popping. Fuck. Oh, shit. Looking dead fucking sick, bro.
There's going to be so many things clipped from this episode. I can just feel it. Good. We've got the TikTok Technodrome, which took me a lot of attempts to go for.
Here's the thing. Everyone, like, I'm underrated on TikTok, I'll tell you. Like, that video of me and Robert Wishart going at each other, it's got, let's see, let's do the live count of it. 368K views. Of me and, like, Robbie just absolutely knocking lumps out of each other. everyone will talk about like the people who like actually do TikTok, but like I'm like, you know, that's a decent clip, and you know, I'm underrated. I'm underrated on TikTok, okay?
Well, originally it was the TikTok czar, but I realized I couldn't say that quickly. It would just come out.
Yeah,
weird.
But also like the alliteration there doesn't really like czar. I get TikTok czar, yeah. But also it like for alliteration to be effective, it needs to be tick tick tick.
Picker pops than Funko.
I get it, but also the implication there is that I get more pops than Terry Funk, in which I don't. Also, that's Terry Funk's new nickname, Funko. Hey, Funko, what's poppin'? Bruh! Yo! Yo! That's mint! Okay, don't delete this. Delete this. I'm keeping that. Yo, I'm tweeting that. Hey, Funko, what's poppin'?
Well, put it out live while we're recording. I mean, I can't wait. I'm starting to get back into the Funko Pops thing, and I'm looking forward to a Terry Funk one, because it has to happen, right?
Does Terry Funk have Twitter?
I think he does.
I've got follow at Real Terry Funk, so let's go Real Terry Funk. Anyway, continue with the
other names. Putting the O in Monster. I think I really should put inflection on the O, like putting the O in Monster.
Putting the oh, like yeah, no. Yeah. I thought it was like, wait, is it like, the, oh. Like an I or an S thing? Putting an O into Monster.
The Relentless Red Bull. I thought throwing some more energy drinks.
That's a nice one. I've always like I once was gonna do a video for like a promotion. I was like, well, listen, I've got a raging Red Bull in my heart, and when I get in that ring, I'll be relentless because you're bringing out the monster in me. I thought that'd be cool, but then I also thought, nah, just like, it just didn't work. I think it's cool. Like, if anyone ever used
could throw in a rock star at the end as well, you know, rock star.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
The Supreme Smacker.
Here's the thing. So the original kind of like Ian Skinner shooter logo actually came from Supreme. I was actually going to call myself like Supreme Ian Skinner, and I had like my initial like logos were like a variation of the Supreme logo. I'll see if I can find it on my phone, because I don't know if you. Like, it's the set of gear that I lost, RIP. It had Shooter on the back. And it was meant to be, like, Supreme, but TJ Rage looked at it and he said, mate, it just looks like the Ladbrokes logo. And I was like, fair. So
Did you have to get rid of Shooter because you're now on the WWE Network?
No. I just think, like, Kick-Ass Ian Skinner sounds cool. The Shooter Ian Skinner, I think there's a lot of people out there who are like the technician, the tactician. I'm not like nothing against them, but like the prize fighter. But I was like, okay, do I want to be another the something? Or do I want to be a guy who's like, I'm Kick-Ass Ian Skinner. I am Kick-Ass, you know? And also I like the movie Kick-Ass. You can see that it's Shooter on the back. It was meant to be Shooter in red because I had red on the front. Meant to be red, red, red. But then TJ said it looks like the Ladbrokes logo. And I'm like, okay, so I'll change it to black. I miss those. Those are my the OGs. It'd be like, it's a shame that I don't have the same kind of like gear that I, you know, had when I started. Because I left my bag on. I left my bag on a train. because there was and like there's someone from my like from work that I was just speaking to. And then I wanted to get off as soon as possible. I was like, oh yeah, cool. Yeah, bye. And I just left, but didn't take my bag. Dumbest decision I ever made. But also, you know, anyway, back to some actual cool questions. Who's the most prolific serial killer?
Oh, that's a good one. I mean, prolific as in just he's got the biggest rep. They've got the biggest rep. I mean, because the best serial killers, of course, are the ones that haven't been caught.
Exact. Cool. You're on to me. You're on to me. I've got it. Not me. I don't know why I looked on the microphone there. Not me. I'm not saying he's on to me, but he's on to my way of thinking.
Yeah, well, I mean, you're killing matches.
That sounds like an insult. Also, just because I'm looking at... Hey, how cool are my T-shirts? Look at that guy. Alex Hughill. I think Hughill or Hughill or Hughill. But, like, his designs are mint. Look at that. Mate, I love comics. So, like, you know, having... Also, like, just the way it's designed as well. And, like, the detail in the background. My arms looking massive. Like, little Ian Skinner at the bottom there. The fact that he did my finger tape as well. Oh, absolutely cool as. I love it. I can't wait to send those out.
I mean, by the time this comes out, people should have got them. Possibly, maybe.
You should. They'll be wearing them while listening to this. And they'll go, wow. I love wearing the merchandise to the person that I'm listening to the podcast to of...
Well, I mean,
but yeah, most prolific serial killer. Go ahead.
Oh God. I mean, I'm not really up to my my serial killer knowledge outside of Dexter. Let's just throw out the classics. You got your Jeffrey Dahmer, you know, Ted Bundy.
Yeah.
The West. What's that other one I'm thinking of? God, what's his name?
Harold Shipman. Richard Ramirez.
That's the name I've heard, but I can't remember where.
It was because ADM, the ADM interview.
That's it.
He was speaking about Ramirez, and I was like, well, listen, ADM. I sent him a message. I was like, listen, ADM, okay? One, again, apologize for pile driving me. That was rude. Secondly, most prolific serial killer, and here's one that you won't, you'll be like, oh yeah, of course. So, what's the one thing that prevents you from looking naked if you don't have knee pads?
Wrist tape, clearly.
My man. Yeah.
I remember things, because that was literally your first comment when I put up going, I'm wearing wrist tape. Although you can see a little bit of an edge of your...
Little bit, but like... Also, I was told that's my best promo picture. My tan isn't even that good.
That was the first goal. The first one was the one where you're doing the pose. That was what I was going to put out.
I have some great pictures from one of my flatmates at the time was a photographer, and he was like, "Oh, do you want to do like a photo shoot?" I'm like, "Yeah, cool, man." So we did one, and so we got a good couple variations. You wanted to try some effects as well. So one of my favorite ones, actually, it's not a favorite one anymore because now it's kind of the gimmicks gone because I'm now 2 weeks energy drink free thanks to gamersups.gg.
Sponsor us or him or sponsor someone.
Yeah, I could apply for the sponsorship, but also they're like, how many followers do you have? And it's like less than 10k to 100k. I'm like, oh God.
Oh, I've got a story about that. Did you send me that one? For the advent calendar.
I sent you a bunch of good ones for the advent calendar. One that everyone seems to like is the, I've broken the swearing rule, the fuckboy one, where it's all on the face, and like, it's like Roderick Strong when he turned, like, when he started being a bad guy with the Undisputed Era, he's like, doing the... What's popping? You were saying...
I was saying about that when you're saying it, sponsorships, all, what's your following like? I contacted Drew McIntyre on Twitter because, you know, we're friends. Yeah. I asked him how to get him on this podcast, thinking, why not? And he gave me an email address to someone in WWE. So I was like, all right, I'll email. And they replied back going, no, you won't get Drew, but you can get someone else who I won't name on this podcast, just in case it happens. No. And then they went, what's your listenership like? And I sent it back, and I have not heard anything since, and that's been 2 weeks. So clearly, they were happy with how many listens I get on this podcast.
See, here's the thing. From a corporate standpoint, I prefer to send someone on to a podcast that has a low listenership, because I wouldn't want someone to come on, eat a cucumber, like, whole, like an absolute savage, ask questions about TikTok to, like, oh, and then, like, 500,000 people listen to it, and they're like, well, now they know that you're just, like, a weird goblin man.
I just really wanted to ask Drew McIntyre what his favourite dinosaur was. What's so wrong about that?
What's the most traumatising family film that you've watched?
Pinocchio.
Mm.
Not even a question, Pinocchio. I hate it, and I still do. I watched it recently, and I still hated it.
Like, overall, like, I think AI did a great thing of making the Pinocchio story just really terrifying. It's like, oh god, yeah, what if he was just like a fake boy, but he looked like a real boy? That'd be mad. Here's a couple. Pee-wee's, I think it's Big Adventure.
I haven't seen it, but like, enough. I know enough about it, yeah.
Yeah, there's that truck where there's just a random jump scare in like a kid's film. Superman 2, the bit where the woman gets turned into a robot by the computer with the stop animation. That's mad, right? The Brothers Grimm. You ever watch The Brothers Grimm?
Nope.
So a bunch of kids get kidnapped by a witch in it. But it's absolutely horrifying. There's this one where like, a kid's at a well and a bird kind of goes, ah, and then like starts flapping its wings and it puts all this like mud on this kid. And then the kid's like, ah, and they wipe away the mud and then they've got no face. They're their face is gone. And then like there's this like weird like mud like thing. It's only little. It's like cutesy. Like if you saw it, you'd be like, oh, it's like got like some Baby Yoda quality to it. But it's chasing after this kid with no face and the kid can't see because they don't have eyes. And it's just like, ah. You know, but it's good because that's kind of like a Grimm Brothers kind of thing, you know, that like, oh, it's a fairy tale, but it's kind of horrifying. There's another one as well where there's like spiders in like a horse's mouth and this kid's like, oh, hi, horse. Oh, and then like the webbing gets on her and then the horse is like panicking and the girl's panicking and she gets like bundled up in like a spider's web and the horse runs off into the forest carrying like the kid from its mouth in a sack. Bruh, like, I don't need that. I don't need that stress in my life.
Yeah, I'm not going to watch anytime soon.
Billy, here's a question. So you tweeted out, all Swedish people look like they wash themselves with Vimto. Can you explain your thoughts behind that?
It was a very difficult time for me. I just had...
some Ribena.
I was drinking Ribena watching ABBA. Mamma Mia 2, by the way, that was what I was watching. So I was just a tough time in my life. Cher did it.
Exactly. So build a Survivor Series team.
Are we still the serial killers route? Because, I mean, I think they do pretty well.
Yeah, fuck it. Go on.
Well, you're going to get a tag team.
I swore!
We should get a buzzer. I don't have a buzzer. I've got...
Nice. I feel that feels rewarding. Like,
well done. There you go. No, you need a tag team. So obviously it's the West. You gotta get them. They've got a cohesion. I don't know. I feel this is gonna go down a really dark path. Who's anyone with a gun? Maybe that they probably. The Rock.
No, you're saying, oh, it's going down the serial killer's route. Are you trying to imply The Rock is a serial killer?
Have you seen Doom?
Okay. Maybe if you contextualize it as The Rock in the film Doom.
No, just The Rock. That's so
Okay.
And there's five of them. So I've got the West. A guy with a gun, The Rock, it's a tough one. You know what, I'm going to choose Dean Ford. He could be the last one, just because.
Again, are you trying to imply that Dean's a serial killer?
I've got no follow-up joke for that. I just thought Dean Ford would be pretty good in that team.
And he'd be like...
Exactly. That's it. That's his whole role for the whole thing. It's just he's in the corner. Just thumbs up.
Right. Oh, I'm sure I made a Survivor Series team and just like put it up on. I better not have deleted it because that was actually a good one. Right. So McBain, Lieutenant Aldo Rain from Inglourious Basterds. I'll say John Wayne Gacy because you're like, oh, he's a clown. And then he's like, That's three, and then I can just end it with a tag team. Jack the Ripper and Shoe Fetish Killer.
is that a general tag team? Is that just
yeah?
Okay, cool.
Oh, who's the guy who killed John Lennon? I was going to say Elton John. He's still alive.
No, John Lennon. So for disclaimer purposes, Elton John did not kill John Lennon. Wow. That we know of.
My notes seem to say otherwise, Billy.
I don't want to Google on my work PC who killed John.
That'll be my Survivor Series team, right? So,
Yoko Ono.
John, Paul, George, Ringo, and Splinter.
the Teenage Mutant Ninja Beatles.
Yeah, it's all that, as I like to call it, the fucking rat. So whenever you've got like a team of four, you always go, and the fucking rat. Because that's how one of my friends once described the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. He's like, Michelangelo, Leonardo, Raphael, Donatello, and the fucking rat. I was like, yes, the fucking rat.
No respect for April.
Yeah, she's a reporter. She's a reporter. She's a fucking rat. I respect a superhero team, but still, like, yeah, I'll eat pizza.
Get a bit of PR, you know, it's all good. Right, let's throw our question at you, since you've asked me quite a few. I don't even know what this means. What's your favorite loadout, and where's your favorite place to drop in Verdansk?
Here's the thing. What favorite place to drop? So this is in like Call of Duty Warzone. Favorite place to drop. It's different depending, but like on like the path that the plane's going. It's like Fortnite, PUBG, that where the plane's going, but also where the hotspots are. So ideally, I like to go around the edge of the map, depending, because you don't want to drop in a hot zone, or at least like that's my technique. Don't drop in a hot zone. Kind of like stick about on the areas until it starts closing in, and then that's when you. Like, combat isn't necessary. I think that's maybe why I'm not so good at the game. But also, maybe it's a symptom of why I'm not so, you know, it's like, I don't get into combat, so I'm not good at the game, but I also don't get into combat because I'm not good at the game. It's an everlasting cycle. It's like incline bench. I lift more on incline bench because I'm stronger on incline bench. So I only ever do incline bench because I'm good at incline bench, because I'm stronger at incline bench, so I'll only ever do incline bench. Because I'm good at incline bench. Because I'm stronger at incline bench. So on and so forth. So, my favourite loadout. Oh, go ahead.
I was going to say, just what I'm getting from that is Ian Skinner likes edging. Got it. Right. And loadout. Which that's a prayer. That's a horrible way to
wow. Oh, Jesus. Okay, like, I'm pulling, like, I'm just like, you've been so polite. And then all of a sudden you're just like, guess what, Ian?
You like I'm edging? Pulling... What's your loadout? Go for it.
is that your sliding into the DMs like, hey yo, heard you like edging. What's your loadout, B? And then you put like that red B.
Jesse missed out.
No, I don't want any more of this. Okay, I wanna be like, hey Jesse, can we be just mates now? And she's like, guess what, Ian? You called me. I'm like, nah. So my loadout, my go-to, I found out that I'll probably be changing it soon because I found out that I've been making my loadout really inefficiently. So I like to go for an M4A, kind of like assault rifle, and then an LMG, which is like usually like the, I don't know what the name of it was. But it turns out they use both the same ammo, so I just keep running out of ammo and being like, ah! So ideally I'd probably be like a M4A, A1 assault rifle, and then like an MP5 or a P90 something. I like to go with like hybrid scopes, so I can do long distance, and then one of them I'll have a thermal scope on just in case no one's got ghost, so I can like pop it like long range. Equipment, smoke grenade maybe, and then like a Semtex. I like Semtex, Molotov maybe, I don't know. I'm not good at the game.
Fine, because Judas Gray also wins.
Two wins after the other when I went on stream with Awesome Rob. Two wins, one after another. I was the last person, and then I actually got the last kill on the other game. So I'm technically good when I've got people around me. But also, they got more kills in the game. But here's the thing. They got more kills. I got the final kill. So who's carrying who?
Judas also asked, we'll get them on the WWE Network. If he keeps carrying your Warzone.
Again, he kept calling me WWE Superstar. I'm not a WWE Superstar. I don't have a contract with WWE. Because I don't want to get sued for implying that I'm a WWE Superstar. I am on the WWE Network. You can watch me then if you want for ICW Fight Club. Will I get him on the WWE Network? No, your skills and abilities will get you to the WWE Network. And Judas Gray is a very skilled person. Oh, God, I've now put one person over, so now everyone will be like, oh, why didn't you mention me in the interview? Why didn't you? So what I decided to do then after that was, okay, we've obviously been there for the full 8 hours. I hook him in, round the back, lift him up in the air, burning hammer, one, two, he kicks out. I'm like, bruh. So I set him up the Warrior's Way, so like the double stomp. So from the top, I'm like, okay, so I'm like set up for the double stomp. Big old kind of like leap in the air, right, okay? And like I'm aiming for his head. I'm aiming for the head. And the head comes off.
What?
I know, right?
That is unbelievable.
Whoever asked for that story, thanks very much. You know, it was a mad one. I'm sure like we'll be able to like, obviously it was a very long story, so you know this might be a really long interview.
There was a little bit of a technical issue. Have got all of that.
But you got the main part with the dogs, and when Ken Shamrock came in and he's like, listen, brother, okay? And like he pulled me up from a cliff. You got that, yeah?
Maybe. I don't know. I think the thing came up was when like just before I asked the question, but you were so excited about it that I didn't want to interrupt you, and then it's just come back online.
What? That was 45 minutes ago I started that story.
Yeah. And in the meantime, we've got a question in from Jessie. She just asked, why do you think she's heavy?
I don't! Oh! Ah! That was the best, that was my 5-star match! Oh, God, I'm not, okay, I can't talk about it again. You just, like, someone will need to, like, seek it out. Oh, man.
I'll find it, I'm sure. Let's move on to Grant McIver. He asked, is 2000s Kylie greater than 80s Kylie?
Yes. Yeah, what's the one that Kylie did in the 2000s? She's got a Minogue.
Spinning around?
Yeah. Like, that's a classic. Like, it's like early Madonna's a lot better than, like, you know, like, oh, here's the thing. You know the ABBA song? Like, speaking of ABBA, the ABBA song, Man After Midnight.
Yep. Gimme.
I didn't realize that was, an ABBA song until like the last couple years. In my head, it was always the Madonna song.
Oh, every little thing that you say I do, hung up. That's the one.
Yeah.
So shocking. I mean, it's almost as shocking as your story about that match, but unfortunately.
Okay, don't bring it up. Okay, it's like it just like it's an emotionally cathartic story because that's literally when Kenta came out and said, "Listen, you know who your real dad is. And then obviously he told me who my real dad was, and I was shocked. And like, you as well, you were shocked. You even had to like, you had to like, okay, I'm going to carve this out in stone. And
I mean, at one point I was naked. I don't know how that happened, but it just was part of the...
Exactly.
It was just... anyway, did Jenny Frost cause Atomic Kitten to be more or less successful than Katona? Asking the big questions here.
See, Atomic Kitten went downhill after Kerry started doing the Iceland ads. Maybe a controversial kind of opinion, but Iceland, Atomic Kitten. Who do you polar buy your food from?
Polar opposites.
Exactly.
So who's the best Spice Girl and why is it Mel C? These are all from Grant McIver.
Mel B. Because of the Bo Selector bit of that. I'm Mel B. You bastard, you.
I was a big fan of Baby Spice in my youth when I was young.
Like, yeah, no, Baby Spice was always kind of like, I think like Mel B was underrated. Scary Spice, you know? Like, she like committed to the leopard print. Everyone else was kind of like, oh, I'm so sporty. I mean, no, the commitment to being like incredible. Incredible commitment to character.
It's because she was in The Masked Singer. If you were to dress up as a masked thing for The Masked Singer, what would it be?
Probably a bank robber.
Just go and go, right, to Fina McCall. Give us your money.
Give us your money, yeah. Easy. And then I don't have to sing.
Exactly. Even better.
And it also gives me like that kind of like the Tyler Creator like goblin vibe. It's like, yeah. And I can do like some like night light hit stuff and turning kisses to bites.
Exactly.
That's an awfully hot coffee pot.
I've never felt so white. And where? He's put where. That's not correct. Grant McIver.
Incorrect grammar. Sure. To the shed with shocking. You.
He's put, were 1D successful more than most 2000s boy bands because they retained a more teenage look than Westlife, etc.?
Well, here's the thing. I think One Direction started younger. So they were more relatable than like Westlife and such, because Westlife, when they started, they must have been like over 18. They always had that more masculine kind of like vibe.
Men.
But here's the thing that's like, it's for retention and the adjustment to the climate rather than staying the same. For example, like a Backstreet Boys or NSYNC, they kind of like lost their youthfulness over time, but they kept trying to do the same songs, you know? They kept trying to do the, oh, my heart and my love for you. Whereas like, One Direction is like, that's what makes you beautiful, and they're like, and let me kiss you, and like it got a bit more kind of like, as it went on, a bit more kind of like, okay, we're teenagers now, we're kind of like discovering ourselves, Little Red Dress, and now Zayn's like, oh, let's piss off the neighbors. Oh, okay, yeah, but I think One Direction and their marketing and like kind of like how they've developed over time, it's been perfect. They've kind of like come into their own alongside the people who were listening to them at the time. Zayn, yeah. You know, obviously Harry's doing his own thing, Niall's doing his own thing, like with the acoustic stuff. They're all like, they've now split, but they're doing their own things. You don't want to be in the kind of like take that realm of, you know, where you're just like, oh, Robbie Williams, are you in the band? yeah, cool. Do you want to leave so we can get some publicity? And then you can join again. Oh, yeah, that sounds good. Cheers, Robbie. Thank you.
And then Jason left and everyone went,
who? Like, who's that?
Wait, what? There's only three of them.
But Westlife and Blue and stuff, they were all like, when we were younger, they were like older men than... Like,
yeah, I mean, and also to say to Grant here that One Direction came out in 2010, so it's like a different kind of decade and era, and all that kind of stuff. Did you know if you put is it sugar on your cucumber, it tastes like watermelon? Is that the trend?
Is that what the song's about?
No, it's just I think I saw it on the TikTok. If you put sugar on on a bit of cucumber and eat it. I'm just gonna Google it. Maybe in salt. So if you're joining us, we've had some technical difficulties this time. I am now recording from a different device in the hopes... Oh, and it's back. Okay.
Yeah. What? Is watermelon just like sweet cucumber?
Seems to be.
The granulatedness of it isn't nice. It's like the classic thing, like onions and potatoes and apples all taste the same. Because they all just taste of starch.
Ah. Yeah, I suppose.
Well, it's just about the way that you prepare them. Like, yeah. You can bite it, like, I'm sure there's, like, something where, like, a dude, like, bit into an onion and bit into an apple because they're similar. And he's like, okay, I think that's the apple. And he's like, well, no, it's an onion. And he's like, oh, fuck.
So yeah, educational here on the SWM podcast.
What the fuck?
So for anyone who missed that, if you put sugar on a cucumber, it tastes like a watermelon. That's my news voice there. Last Minute Wrestling Podcast, our pal Frank. He has asked, who really is the one who discovered you? And is it true he heard it was a person that comes from Italy?
There is one. I'll just go serious for a moment. I think the person who discovered me, or at least like discovered my potential, was Krieger. Because I think that... Like being serious, you know, we've all had laughs, we've all had memes and jokes, jokes. Here's the thing, jokes. Here's something I've recently found out. If you say, like, you know, there's the way of saying doggos, you know, oh, there's a bunch of doggos. If you say doggos with a Scandinavian twinge to it, it sounds a lot cooler. Doggos.
Wait, what am I going for?
Dog. You're going for Swedish.
I'm going for Swedish. Yeah. I picked the wrong Scandinavian one.
It's all about the dog. Dogos.
Dogos.
It sounds a lot cooler. Yeah, it sounds more like... They sound like wolves, you know? Like, oh, the dogos. Jon Snow, the dogos. But yeah, in training, Krieger always used to, like, understand, like, some of the things that I was doing. And, like, he's always... Like, I think it took a while for TJ to, like acclimatize to, like, Ring of Honor. But, like, Krieger always, like, he's always like, right. Like, he's done mixed martial arts. So that's the standpoint he's coming from, rather than, I'm in it for, like, body slams and, like, that kind of stuff. So I think Krieger's always, like, putting a good word for me, or being able to be, like, no, but I can see where you were coming from when doing stuff like that. So I don't think I put him over enough. I do it on Twitter a lot, but on interviews, I never put him over enough. So, you know, I've now said it. So now next time he's on an interview.
Yeah, exactly. I'll tell him. He's actually on the episode, I think, like two episodes before this one.
Did he say that I was good?
I don't think he mentioned you.
Okay. I feel really bad for, like, showing the knife. I feel really bad. I don't carry a knife on me. I have it at home for, like, cutting stuff.
And obviously the cucumber as well. Well, the watermelon. The watermelon that you've got now.
Oh, yeah.
So I think that's all the questions, I mean, that I've received. And I mean, the only stuff I've really organized is obviously the really long winded names. Oh, yeah. I can't remember if I asked you at the time, what was your favorite dinosaur?
No, you didn't. And that's literally one of the reasons why I need a second interview, because I feel like there's like some questions at the end that I didn't receive, because I was kind of like one of the first couple people that you did.
Yeah, I think you're episode 6, maybe something like that. Yeah. Really early on.
So like it was like when it was just very much kind of like, like you hadn't gotten, not saying you hadn't gotten into the swing of things, but like you were still kind of like getting the kind of like bumps and bruises on the go. You know, I like T-Rex is an OG, you know, like he's the one, like I voted for him in the poll because I'm like, cool, I think he needs a majority win. Raptors, they're cool, but Bad Boys, like they're kind of like the, they're like Randy Orton, you know. Raptors of the Randy Orton's of the Dinosaur Kingdom. You know, as an OG, I'd say he's maybe like the Roman Reigns or like the Bobby Lashley, like 2007 Bobby Lashley of dinosaurs. Spinosaurus.
All right.
Remember when Jurassic Park 3 came out? And it was literally like, well, fuck T-Rexes. Shit this bad boy out. And they did like the crocodile thing where the Spinosaurus was in the water and it's like the spine was coming out. And like, I think there's a scene in that film where the Spinosaurus just absolutely murks like a T-Rex. I'm pure excited for Godzilla versus King Kong. How can you make a better movie than Big Monkey versus Big Lizard? Mate, I love the kaiju films. Like,
my question though is Jamiroquai doing the soundtrack?
No.
No,
but also, that wasn't a Godzilla film.
It says Godzilla.
Godzilla, but it'd be like Jacob's Ladder. Where's the ladder in that film?
No wait, that's definitely not, that's a bad example. I was basically Schindler's List. I thought there is a list somewhere in that.
Billy.
This is why I don't get asked to do interviews quite a lot.
You started this yourself.
I know.
Like, it's not as if I asked, like, well, what's the film? You're like,
you've lulled me into a false sense of security where I can say.
Oh yeah, because I've been saying a bunch of horrendous shit in this, haven't I? I mean, yes, but like.
You asked the serial killer question first, and then that's just kind of made it all.
Like, it's all when I mentioned serial killers, it all went downhill.
It's like a trigger. I went, oh, I could just say anything I want here.
It's like the it's like your MK Ultra, like secret spy, like serial killers.
Speaking of cereal, I was trying to have. I had Rice Krispies this morning. They were great. Anyway, right. The other question I've got prepared is. What would win in a fight, two sheep or one cow?
Here's the thing. Two sheep, maybe not. Three sheep, yes.
Show me your working.
So I think, like two sheep, I think a cow is big enough, like if it's a bull, to take on the two sheep. Even if like it's like male on male, like a combination, I feel like a cow can like absolutely murk one. And then, like, murk the other in, like, a swift kind of, like, fuck you. A third sheep, though, then, like, the cow has to be laterally thinking because they've got, like, the... It's not just a pincer movement because I think a cow can get out of a pincer movement. He's kind of, like, in, like, a triangle in which as soon as he's focusing on one, the other two can attack. Whereas, like, if he's focusing on one and another one attacks, he can bop them out of the way. So I think here's one, though. What would win in a fight? One cat or three mice?
I'm going to go for... I mean, you would think the cat, but it depends on how the mice get underneath. If they're able to get underneath, there might be...
Also, mice are great at kind of like strategic. Squirrels as well. There's a video on YouTube of a guy who's like set up an obstacle course in his back garden. And the squirrels have to go all the way around the obstacle course to get to, like, the nuts at the end, like the almonds or whatever. And the squirrels are so good at, like, getting, the technique. And, some of them, like, they try different things. And they all have their own little personalities. It was mint. I can't remember what the video's called, but... Give it a... Find it.
All right, okay.
Well, mice... Five mice could take a cat. Three mice, maybe not. But five, done.
I mean, and if it's three blind mice, I suppose their movement would be so erratic. How would the cat be able to...
I think the blind mice have more of an advantage in this game.
They could fight the dark.
Yeah. Also, okay, so what would you rather fight? One big cat or a dog with a gun?
Oh, that's a tough one.
And Big Cat, I mean like a cheetah panther, like.
Right, I've got follow-up questions. How big are the pot? Does the pot? I mean, how does the dog operate the gun?
He's got a gun. He's got an Uzi, like.
No, but like, how does
like you don't know? Kind of like you're
right, okay.
Two rooms. You're like, okay, you can either fight a big cat and you don't know which big cat it is, or there's a dog in that room with a gun. Which do you decide?
I think I would take my chances with the dog with the gun. I'm allergic to cats, so I don't want to die that way.
That'd be like, what happened? Well, he sneezed himself to death, and then like his throat became inflamed. Cat didn't even touch him. He was in the room with
I'll walk into the room, my face just swells up. I'm like, oh, no. But yeah, I'll go for the dog. I mean, I'd feel guilty about it, but if a dog came at me with a knife or a gun, I'd kick it. I wouldn't enjoy it, but it'd have to be done.
Fair. Well, thanks very much for watching, everyone. You've tuned into the SWN podcast. I hope you had a great time, a great listening experience. The most, let's call it the most chaotic Scottish wrestling podcast available right now, as in only this episode, not the actual show, just the episode.
I mean, we found out that Ian enjoys edging, and
why? Why are you bringing that back up?
because you tried to end it with me finishing saying I would kick a dog, and I'm not having that as the last.
You saw through my lies.
I'm not having the last moment of this podcast being me going I'd kick a dog, because no, I'm not having it. All right, we've got more questions.
But now it is.
No. Caleb Valhalla asked, what's your top 5 energy drinks / flavors? I don't know if that's two.
Okay, so my number one will be Gamer Subs. Just now. It's Blue Raspberry. They've also got, I can't remember what it's called, like Passion? No, Dragon Fruit Crunch. Yeah, kind of tastes like a Gobstopper. It's really cool. So that'll be my number one in there, kind of like two flavors. Because I don't think like different flavors. Yeah. Monster Ultra, white and black. So Monster Ultra Black, have you tried it yet?
Black, no, I can't find it here.
Highly recommend. I think you can get it on Amazon. So you can get a multi-pack on Amazon. I highly recommend it. One of these bad boys. Again, I'm 2 weeks energy drink free. I have those sitting there. It's kind of like the classic, like, oh, I put a cigarette in my mouth because it makes me close away from death. I didn't on purposely do that. It's just how it's that. And underneath Monster Ultra, I say Relentless. Or no, Red Bull, then Relentless. So Gamer Subs, Monster Ultra, just only Ultra. I don't like normal Monster. Red Bull, Relentless. And then between Rockstar and Monster, I'd say... interesting one. Grenade's energy drink sucks. I won't recommend that. It's really bad. Not really bad, but like I just it's like, oh well, that tastes like petrol. What's the last one? Interesting. Maybe Rockstar, because it tastes a bit more, it's like it's super sweet. Here's the thing, normal Monster taste like sticky in the mouth. Rockstar still goes down, but it's super sweet. So it's kind of like that's the dichotomy that I've got. Yeah, we'll go with that.
Cool. Fine. Right. So definitely not the questions I think we may have.
Or pre-workout. Oh yeah, no pre-workout. Go with like here's one. So there's a company called Redcon. Redcon One, I wouldn't recommend it because like shipping costs were so. Redcon Total War, Kenny Omega is a flavor. It's Lemonheads kind of flavor. It's called V Trigger. I'll call that an energy drink because I have it before the gym. It tastes sweet. It's great. It's got Kenny Omega on it, and it's a pre workout. Really cool. Again, it's a good flavor, but think about like. So, how many servings does it have? Let's see, 30 servings. 30 servings, yeah. You might want to think about like where your money's going because the shipping, because it comes from the US, is a fair bit. I got it on Black Friday, so I got like a t-shirt and like a weightlifting belt and some stuff, like all in one. But it was still an arm and a leg. but I thought it'd be worth it.
Oh yeah, I mean, I mean, nowadays, of course, it's going to be even more expensive to get stuff from the US. Real world.
And also the gyms are closed, so I'm not been able to. I would not recommend using pre-workout as like, oh, it's just an energy drink. No, if you want to go hard in the paint in the gym, heavy deadlift day, heavy squat day, total wall, recommend.
Right, I think we may have lost a couple of questions before, of course, we don't want to go through the story again because, it was a tough time for you. How much do you love ciabatta? Every time I read that, I keep thinking of bread. That sounds like ciabatta.
He's one of my idols.
Cool, that's fine. I'm sure you spoke about him at length for the in our last chat, in our award-winning chat. I don't know
how that happened. I didn't even have that many views, but I guess I'm just a person that people go.
I mean, you had a fair few views. I mean, it went up after you won, which is great for me.
How many views? Because last time I looked at it, I think it was on 69 views, was it?
Nice. I think it's on 78 now. But it's on Facebook and it's on audio, so I mean, it does accumulate.
Let's have a look before we go. Also, Adam Morrison, the video that he did of SWN podcast has its own YouTube channel. So I was on the Scottish Wrestling Network YouTube channel.
I know, why would you have two? But that's just because Adam set that one up. I thought, oh, I'll do it separately. I'm not planning to do any videos anytime soon. Then I started a podcast.
Yeah, 78. Everyone else has got over 100 views. I don't know how it happened. Anyway.
The little engine that got the votes.
You call me little.
No. No, that's... what did I get out of this one? The West. Right, I've run out of questions. I don't think anyone else is coming in, other than, of course, that Jesse one, which thank you, Jesse, for sending in a question. Ian does not regret at all calling you heavy.
No! You take that back, you son of a bitch.
That, okay, I'm sorry. He doesn't regret calling you heavy.
No, no! you just said the same thing.
No.
You said that I don't. You said that I don't regret it. I do. Right, no, I didn't. I didn't call him heavy. Okay, no, we're ending this. End it now.
I think this is the best way to end it. Thank you for watching the SWN podcast and listening. This has been a three-hour recording that you might only hear 90 minutes of. I never plug my stuff in these podcasts, so I'll do that while you have your existential crisis about calling Jesse heavy. You can buy the merch on swnscotland.com. You can visit us on Twitter at ScottResNet. We're on patreon.com/ScottResNet. This has been Billy Strachan. I have been joined by Ian Skinner.
At Ian Skinner PW on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok.
And thank you for watching.